Doubling your money. It surely sounds good to the ear, right? Imagine investing 10,000 ringgit and after a while it becomes 20,000. Surely it feels good. Something that we can boast about. But how long does it take to double your money? Can you do it in a short period of time? Let's say 5 years. Is there a safe way to do that? Today, I'll share with you a portfolio that you can use to double your money in 5 years. Watch till the end of the video. Woo! Hi, welcome back to Mr. Money TV, bringing you the best tips and tools for a better future. If you enjoy my content, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification to get notified of the latest money tips. And if you enjoy this video, please help me by clicking the like button because that will really help me with my YouTube algorithm to reach more people with my content. For those of you who are more active on Facebook and Instagram, we also have a Facebook page and an Instagram account. So do follow us there as well. Now, let's not waste time and get into today's topic, how to double your money in 5 years. If you want to double your money in 5 years, you need to know how much of return you need yearly to double your money. And the easiest way is to use the rule of 72. It's a way to calculate how long it takes to double your money. Well, I've done a video on the rule of 72. You can check it out in my channel. I also attached the link here and in the description. So do check out that video. Now, based on the rule of 72, you will need an annual return of 14.4% per year to double your money. So all you need to do right now is to find an investment that can give you at least 14.4% annual return per year. So that's all. Thank you. You can Google it up. I'll see you. No, just kidding. Anyway, it's not right just looking at one investment and say that that investment has 14.4%, then my money will double. Well, yes, there are many things in the market that can give you about 14.4% return annually, but we can't invest everything in just one vehicle, right? It is like putting all your eggs in one basket. Most of the time, we are supposed to spread our risks and not put all our eggs in one basket. So here's a guide on how can you double your money in 5 years with a portfolio. Now, first, read this. So this portfolio that I'm recommending will work regardless if you have 10,000 or 100,000 or 1 million. But to make it easy, we'll use 100,000 as an example. So the first thing, split your investment into three parts: a low risk, medium risk, and high risk. And in this portfolio, we will put 10% into low risk investment such as bonds, ASB, ASM. Usually you will get around 3% to 7% annual return. Then 80% of the money to be put into a medium risk investment tool such as REITs, blue chip stock, mutual funds that has good track record. Usually such investment will give you around 7% to 15% annual return. Then the remaining 10% of your money to be put into a high risk investment. Things that can give you around 30% to 50% a year. Now, you may be wondering right now, what on earth can give such a high return? Yes, they are. Firstly, it can be used to invest into businesses or startups. For example, people who invested in Google or Facebook at their early stage got about 1,000-fold in return. And this is not uncommon among investing in businesses. Previously, investing in early stage companies or startups would require you to have the kind of connection with rich people or you yourself is a very rich guy. But these days with crowdfunding, you can easily get your hands on some great early startups. You can check out platforms like Pitchin to learn about crowdfunding investing. Or else, you can also start your own business and give it a try. Who knows? Maybe you'll be the next Bill Gates, Jeff Bezos, or Mark Zuckerberg. Secondly, you can invest in hedge funds. Now, we have seen some hedge funds that consistently make around 60% return a year. But usually for hedge fund, there's a minimum investment amount that's at least $100,000 And it is reserved for only the high net worth individuals. So if you're one high net worth individual, lucky you, you can invest in a hedge fund. But if you're not a high net worth individual, then your choice is a poor man's hedge fund. And that's what I call a copy trading or hire own trader. You can find a trader who has a good track record and hire the person, put your money with them and ask them to trade on your behalf. Since day traders are much more active with the way that they trade, they're always seeking opportunity to make money daily from the market. So there's a chance that they can make a good yearly return for you. Well, if you do not know any trader, you can also try out things like eToro's copy trading, where you can copy the trades of other traders. There are quite some good traders there and many different kind of traders that you can choose from. Some of them are even making more than 50% return even in this bad market right now. Well, in eToro, you can just copy their trades by choosing to copy them. You can also choose to automatically stop copying them if their copy value drops. You can check out eToro in the link from the description below. It's free to open an account, so explore yourself. Finally, learn to day trade yourself. You can learn to day trade yourself and make good profits too. But learning how to day trade does require a lot of time and a lot of discipline. So if you can do that, maybe you'll become a good day trader and make some good money. Now you have allocated all your assets and ta-da! This is what you can get after 5 years. Your low risk investment compounding at 5%, you will get about 12,762 ringgit. And for the medium risk compounding at 12% average, you will get around 140,987 ringgit. And for the high risk part, compounding at 40% a year, you'll get 53,782 ringgit and 40 cent. So that's a total of, ta-da! This is what you can get after 5 years. That is the sound of doubling your investment. Now, definitely this is just a projection. You may wonder to yourself, this looks too good to be true. What if the high risk investment lose everything and the projection doesn't go according to plan? Is this still going to be better than investing in fixed deposit or putting my money into something else that's very, very safe? Let's change the result right now. Let's say if you were to lose everything in the high risk investment and for the medium risk investment, you only make an average of 8%. This will still leave you with 130,309 ringgit. This is quite sad, but it can happen, right? But how does it fare against just putting your money in fixed deposit? Is it really going to be better? Now, if you only invest in fixed deposit, which give you around 4% return for 5 years, that amount would be 121,665. So what do you think? Do you think it's better to take a little bit of risk or just invest everything into fixed deposit? Now, what more when government right now is cutting interest rate? Your FD will likely not get 4%. The base rate right now is only at about 2% plus. Yep. So I would suggest to take a little bit more aggressive stand and learn how to invest. But it's your choice. Now, as we can see here, through a little bit of financial knowledge and portfolio management, you can reduce your risk significantly and increase your return. And that's how you can use a portfolio to double your investment in 5 years. This portfolio management will work for you whether you have 10,000 or 1 million ringgit. Just that with a smaller amount, you have less choice. But these days, with more and more fintech innovation, you can invest in things that used to be only available for the high net worth, such as hiring trader and investing in early stage of startup. So that should give you more opportunity and option to double your money. Now, what do you think? Do you have a portfolio idea that you can share with us or that you are already using? Do share with us in the comments below. And as I have shown earlier and say earlier, this is not an investment recommendation and there's no guarantee return. It is important to spread out your risk accordingly and speak to your financial advisor before you invest. That's all for today's episode. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.